literally passing the torch.
Our first glimpse of the cauldron. Designed by Thomas Heatherwick. It really is a stunning work of art. One of the most closely guarded secrets of this whole ceremony.
Desiree, it was magical for all of us watching that. I can't imagine what it was like to stand there and watch those wonderful stems closing up. Can you describe the moment when you lit your copper petal?
I think that was the moment when I realised, wow, I'm actually about to make history. And then just to see the light go up, my heart literally started beating. At one point, I actually thought I was about to cry because it was an absolutely magical moment and I was just so proud to be a part of it.
And the music of the moment was really just so special for that particular second, wasn't it?
Exactly. I think even today, I just keep hearing the same song over and over in my head because it's just reminding me of what I was actually a part of, and it's just absolutely amazing.
I think everybody applauded the sentiment of literally passing the torch, as we said on Friday night, to the younger generation. You're only 16. You're already a world youth champion at 200 metres, and you did that at 15 years of age. And unfortunately for you, the only thing that's going to top that experience now is winning Olympic gold. But how much inspiration do you draw from that experience and you can take forward now?
I think for me personally, with it being actually in the Olympic Stadium, that's motivation in itself. And then for a person as great as Tom Daley to pass the baton, the torch to me, and for me to be able to light it, I think, as you said, the only thing that would be able to top it is me winning an Olympic gold. But then again, I just think in 4 years' time, I'll be going to Brazil, Rio de Janeiro. Maybe not gold there, as it will be my first Olympics at the time. But then I just think in the future, it will just keep motivating me to keep working hard and hopefully come back with that gold.
I love the way she's saying, in 4 years' time, you'll be my first Olympics.
Absolutely, you know, yes, you've got to feel confident.
The way you plan your career then, mm-hmm. you're looking at that, but you reckon there'll be another Olympic Games for you after that, if all goes well.
Yes, if all goes well. I think I'm just thinking realistically in terms of being an athlete and a young female athlete, that my first Olympics, that will be where I basically get experience as a young athlete, and hopefully I can bring that experience into the following Olympics, hopefully, and just come out there and maybe shine.
Daley Thompson, Did you know him? Have you met him before?
I think that was a big surprise for me because I didn't actually know Daley Thompson, and for him to personally nominate me, I was just like, wow, he knows who I am type of thing. So I was just in shock and in awe of him personally, and to meet him was just an amazing experience.
You were born, 12 years after his second gold medal
in
the decathlon. How aware are you of his history, of the history of British Olympians? Is it something that interests you, or is it all about your career from here on?
I think during the build-up of the Olympics, there's been so many TV shows just basically telling us about just the great Olympians, and he appeared on there many times, so that kind of educated me about him, and that just kind of made me feel even more special that such a great man basically asked me to light the cauldron. So that was a real opportunity.
Have you left this torch anywhere? Has it left your side at all since
No, I've been with it every single day, and it's been with me literally. I think the first night that I came home, I actually slept with it because I just thought, wow, I don't want nobody to take this moment or the torch away from me. Well, so yeah.
But it's great to have it because that is a symbol really of what your aspiration will be.
Yes.